Hey, I'm back here with Ryan Carr from Air Solutions. And Ryan, you may have heard me say earlier when speaking to Derek that we had him try 17 new technologies, products that he hadn't seen or used before, even products that I haven't seen or used before. And you brought to our attention this really cool, what it's called medium static air source heat pump made by Fujitsu. When did you first learn about the product and what was most intriguing to you?
Well, it's a newer rollout to the residential catalog. It's something that's been available in VRF technology for some time.
Variable refrigerant technology.
Variable refrigerant flow, right. Yes. Commercial-based systems, but they're now scaling that technology down.
And the advantage, give me a sense of what that inverter technology gets me.
Yeah, so, you know, inverters, you know, very soft startup. They start real low, ramp up. So that's great for solar, being a net zero.
Yeah, even though we're not directly on solar, if we ever wanted to be directly on solar, that'd be really nice, a soft start. Great.
Right, no large inrush current, which is difficult for solar. Yeah. Also, I mean, with inverter style technology, you tend to run lower and longer run times. So being right next to the water, you know, moisture removal is very important. And as you have more dwell time across the coil, you're going to pull out more moisture.
Yeah, that's really important. We know that moisture is a big issue, well, in all places in North America now, in low load houses, latent loads, the moisture loads of the people themselves are difficult. And third thing that you like the best?
Very, very high efficiencies, right? So we're over 21 SEER on this system.
On the air conditioning side?
On the air conditioning side, right.
And on the heating side?
And on the heating side, we're actually over 11.5 from a heating seasonal performance factor.
That is the term, HSPF, heating season performance factor. In a traditional, you know, unitary heat pump, they're typically, what, 8.5, 9 at best?
Thereabouts, yeah.
So this is using that inverter technology that most people would be familiar with the wall mount units, cassette type units. And Fujitsu's turned this into a fully ducted system that has another cool feature in terms of its static capabilities. Just describe that a little bit.
Yeah, so this guy up here, it will automatically adjust. So it takes a lot of the guesswork, the calculation, the commissioning out. Once your ductwork is connected, your filters are in, you start it up, and the initial run process will ensure that it maintains a steady static so that you're getting constant, reliable airflow.
And that's going to be doubly important here because we actually have it zoned. The primary heating here is going to be in floor off the naving we saw earlier, but a little bit of supplemental heat for the second floor, this is delivering that in a zoning context. So either thermostat will call for heating, but primarily that heating is going to be upstairs. And then in the summertime, we again want to use that zoning. So typically warm air is rising, so it's a little warmer up top, but we still want cooling capabilities here if we have a big party. So that constant static with the zone dampers working, it's going to interface nicely. We've chosen our partner here, Zone First, does a really nice zone dampering system, which too helps adjust static pressure. So a kind of cool technology. We're really excited. We actually don't have it powered up yet, so I'm a little disappointed we don't have that, but we're expecting really low noise levels.
Yeah, I mean, that's the other beauty of inverter style systems is definitely a very low operating sound level. And obviously in as tight a home as it is, you know, you showcased the windows and doors earlier. I mean, you want that haven, that quiet space, and this won't disrupt that whatsoever.
And finally, for us, from a design perspective, we had a small mechanical room. It's a slab on grade home. So typically in Canada, we're doing basements. Here, we didn't have that luxury. So this fit into a ceiling space, 12 inches deep. So we're able to just drop the ceiling in the closet area here. And that still maintains for our family all the storage space and basically declutters the mechanical room. As you saw, it's pretty tight mechanical room. So this takes away that. Made it very easy for ducting too, because we're between the floors. And so really optimized the amount of ductwork that we need in the house. You may recall from one of the earlier videos, we did that all in flexible duct. So I'm really keen to see how that all works out.